Hi, I'm Alex, and together with my friend Drew, we develop Agenda, a date-focused note-taking app. Now, every update we make for Agenda comes with a theme. Earlier this year, we added support for tables to Agenda. And now, in Agenda 13, we decided to focus on speed. Now, of course, speed can mean many things. Just how fast the app feels, for example. But also how quickly you can get the things done that you need to do many times during the day. Or, even if you're a new user to Agenda, how quickly you can get off the ground. Now, we made some major improvements in all of these areas in Agenda 13, and I would love to show you them now. Let's start with speed, as in how fast does the app feel. It used to be that if you would add a lot of attachments or photos to your notes, that the app could slow down quite a bit if you would switch between projects or scroll through them. That should be a lot more fluid now in Agenda 13. These are of course not very visible changes, but we did add one thing that could be quite visible, and that's the ability to change the size at which you show full width images inside of your notes. And this is how it works. So here we are in Agenda, in a project with quite a few attachments, and as you see, it scrolls nice and smoothly. What's new in Agenda 13 is that if you show your attachments as full width images, which is a premium feature, you can actually now choose how large exactly you want them to show in your notes. For instance, you might only want it to take up half the size of your note, or even smaller. This can be useful if you want it to be larger than just a small thumbnail, but also not take up the entire note. Of course, if you like to have your images as large as possible, then 100% is the way to go. Now you might ask, what are these premium features he's talking about, and how does that work? Well, Agenda is free to download and free to use for as long as you want, and that includes pretty much everything that the app does. We do have a set of what we call premium features, and those are features that are especially handy for people that use the app a lot. And you buy those using an in-app purchase. The great thing is that those are yours forever to keep. It's not that you lose them if you decide not to pay us again. In fact, in principle, you never have to pay us again if you don't want to. The way it works is you buy them and they're yours to keep, and it even includes 12 months of any features we release after your purchase. After those 12 months are up, of course, any new features, premium features that we would add, you would then have to buy. But only if you feel that the money we're asking is worth those features. That's how it works. Now let's go back to Agenda 13, because this was just a warm-up. That the app feels quick is important. Well, what perhaps it has an even more bigger impact is how quickly you can get the things done that you do many times during the day. And this is especially where we made many improvements. So let me go through that now. So the first thing you'll notice in Agenda 13 is that all the popover menus can now be navigated using the arrow keys. Which is handy because it means that you can hit a keyboard shortcut, use the arrow keys to select the option you want, then hit enter to execute it, all without having to leave your hands from the keyboard. The next thing you'll notice is that those same menus, when they contain templates or projects or notes, can actually be filtered down if you just start typing some of the words in the title, like this. Hitting enter will then just select the remaining option, or if you have multiple ones, you use the arrow keys to select one and then hit enter as well, making it much faster to scroll down or to navigate down these kind of menus. Now this works in all of the menus in the app, but we added one more thing that's even better, which is a new premium feature called Open Quickly. If you hold the Alt Option key and hit space, a menu will appear that allows you to quickly filter through your entire Agenda library of notes and projects. Type a few characters of the note you're looking for, hit enter, and you're there. Now this is on my Mac, but I hear you say, I'd love to have this on my iPad too. And what about Agenda for iPhone? How does that work? Because I don't have one of those. Let me show you how that works. Of course, on iPad and iPhone, you don't have a keyboard. But if you drag down in any of these menus, you will see that it will reveal a search field. And if you continue dragging down, it will actually place the cursor for you in the search field, and you can just filter down just as easily. Just type a few characters, select the one you need, and boom, you're there. For me, this one is going to make a massive difference. I'm switching between these notes all the time, and it's since I started using, of course, the beta versions of Agenda, made massive difference. Now, while we're here, let's look at another area where we added keyboard support that can dramatically make things faster than it used to be. As you know, the key aspect of Agenda is that it's date focused. And this means that you can assign a date or a link an event to your notes. And you do this using the calendar icon in the top right corner of your notes. If you tap that, you will see a calendar picker on the left and a list of your events in your calendar on the right. Now, if you just needed to select today or tomorrow, it's quite easy, but it used to be a lot more hassle if you, say, needed to go back 2 or 3 months. And that has become a lot easier now in Agenda 13, where you can just select the presets button where we added the option to type your date. So you can just type in 3 weeks and it will jump straight there, or say 15th of March 2022. It's that easy and much faster than having to scroll through this. And on the Mac, or if you have a hardware keyboard attached to your iPad, you can actually just start typing and you don't even need to select this preset. What's also great if you have a keyboard is that you now also can use the arrow key. So you can just arrow key up or down or right or left to select a date. So, and if you quickly want to jump to the next month, you just hold the option key, or if you hold the shift key, you can quickly select the date or even a date range. Hit enter and it assigns. And this is especially useful if you're looking for a specific note and you know more or less in which date range it was. Here in the top right corner, next to you click the search icon and you can search on a specific date or date range. And now that you can see which dates have a note, it's much easier to pinpoint where it is. Now we're here. Note that in Agenda 13, we also added a few extra options in filtering, not only on whether a note is on the agenda, but you can also filter notes whether they're done or only show notes that are not done. Let's switch to a different area, which is how do you work on a day-to-day basis and set up your workflows? Many times, an entire project once started as just a single line in some note, a list of things you thought about, or something someone said during a meeting. Ultimately, that as that idea starts to grow, you copy it into a new note, and eventually that note even becomes a new project with many notes and even a category of things, right? That's how Agenda started. And this is something that's a whole world, and I'd love to talk more about it. And if you subscribe to this channel, this is what I will be talking a lot about. But to go back to the process, it can be quite cumbersome because you end up copy-pasting text from one note to the other, or move a note into a new project, etc. Now, all of this is now a lot easier in Agenda 13. And let me show you how that works. So here we're back in Agenda, and we're looking at this note from a particular meeting in which we discussed a whole bunch of things. Now, sometimes these notes can grow quite large and makes actually more sense to divide them up in multiple separate notes. So that's now super easy. You place the cursor in front of where you want it to be split, and you go to the gear menu and you just choose split at insertion point, and boom, Agenda splits the note in two and is even smart enough to recognize that this header should probably be the title of your note that you want to start. Now, this split function is quite clever because if you do this with the cursor at the end, it will actually turn into start a new note. So this can be super useful and save you a ton of time, because instead of having to create a new note, then drag this note to the right place, all you need to do is put the cursor at the end of the note and use this start new note command, which you'll find both in the gear menu or on the note in the main menu. Similarly, if I want a new note before the one I'm working on, you guessed it already, it's as easy as putting the cursor at the start of the note and then choose proceed by new note. Imagine I looked again at these things we discussed during a meeting, and there was this one particular thing which was actually a great idea. And I'd like to work that out into more detail. And the best thing to do that is actually to make that in an entirely new note. Now, what I can do in Agenda 13 is simply select that part of the text and choose move selection to new note. And that will simply extract the text and add it to a new note. A similar feature is if you have a recurring part of a note that you want to have also in a new note. Together, these commands save you a ton of time and will make it much easier to move things around in Agenda. And I think this will dramatically speed up the workflows. And like I said, there's a lot more ground to cover when it comes to these kind of workflows and these kind of methods. And we'll hope to do that in future videos on this channel, which is exactly what brings us to the final point when we talked about speed, which is if you're a new user to Agenda, how do you quickly get up and running? Or if you already use Agenda, how do you get even faster using it? That's what this YouTube channel is about. We'll be posting a lot more videos, video tutorials, but also tips, tricks, power features, and we will talk to other people about how they use Agenda. And you can all find it here. So if you like to see those videos, either subscribe to the channel or go to the agenda.community, where we'll also be posting anytime a new video becomes available. And that's where you can then discuss it, ask questions, etc. And of course, we'll also answer them if you add them here at the video. Well, that's it for Agenda 13. We'll hope you'll give it a try. You can download it from agenda.com or the app stores, or of course, check for updates if you're already running the app. In the meantime, Drew and I will continue working on Agenda 14 for you, and we'll hope to see you soon. Bye bye.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.